It's one thing to identify danger zones that are prone to floods and other risks, but it's another thing to make residents steer clear of these areas or even make them engaged and resilient when it comes to dangers. Now, while government eyes various measures such as relocating settlers along waterways, implementation can be tricky for local politicians who may face strong opposition from their own constituents. DPWH Secretary Rogelio Singson himself revealed some local leaders asked for the suspension of relocation efforts during the election season, a situation that one Metro Manila mayor calls a political reality.
But a study by a British think tank shows disasters can lead to political gain for local officials, especially with political will on disaster prevention. The Overseas Development Institute cites the case of Albay, a province long exposed to typhoons and volcanic eruptions. Now, according to that study, Governor Joey Salceda made disaster prevention a key element of his election campaign and established links with experts and the academe to develop policies and eventually enable communities to rise above disasters. Tony?
And finally, to introduce the man that you are hearing in the background, Albay Governor Joey Salceda.
We'll be talking to him also about his role as Asian representative to the board of the Green Climate Fund. Very interesting discussion we're going to have tonight. So please join a discussion by sending us your comments and questions through Twitter using the hashtag Primetime or post them on our Facebook page. That's ANC247. Governor Joey Salceda, thanks for joining us tonight.
Yeah, good evening. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you too.
What about me?
Nice to see you.
What about me? Am I chopped liver here?
Yeah.
No, I'm just kidding. Thank you very much, Governor, for coming over.
Mm-hmm.
The Green Climate Fund, what we've been hearing is that there are several countries that are actually vying to be the host of this fund. Why shouldn't it be the Philippines?
Actually, the choice was already made.
No.
It's in Korea.
Korea?
In Incheon.
Oh.
But there was, because we are like, what, 184 in the United Nations framework for confluence of parties.
Mm.
So, yung membership dun sa board, yun ang heavily competed.
Okay.
So we won.
Mm-mm.
So there's a term for the board. It's about 3 years, and we're sharing it with Indonesia.
Mm.
So first year sa kanila, and then ako na in September. So we have had 4 meetings already. So on the fifth, I will sit already as the Asian director.
Okay. So let's reconcile that. Membership in the board is what's heavily contested,
uh-oh,
and then hosting the fund is something else. Now, Korea hosting the fund?
Yes.
And then the Philippines has membership in the board?
Yes.
Okay. Now, how does that help us?
Malaki. Kasi actually, if you remember Copenhagen,
mm-mm,
where Obama went,
mm-mm,
and then tried to settle because there was an impasse,
mm-mm,
by offering a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
Well, how will you use the money?
Mm-hmm.
So there was a decision made in Cancun to use that money through a green climate fund.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost like a fund to be used for climate change, mm-hmm, adaptation and mitigation.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So from Cancun, we went to Durban. In the Durban, there was already the implementing rules and then the election of the board.
Mm-hmm.
And now we're going to South Korea already because the board is already sited there.
Mm-hmm.
They gave us one whole building in Incheon. My God, it's one of the best buildings. It's almost like an IT building.
Okay, right. And so with
30 billion yung initial nila up to year 2020.
But it's supposed to be
year.
Total of 100 billion, right?
100 billion per year starting 2020 and thereafter.
Okay. Now
that's 4 trillion, huh?
As part of the board, what is the Philippines authorized to do in way of approving how the fund is used for climate change mitigation measures?
Our interest is in adaptation. Immediately, you hit on a very big issue. Mitigation, if the Philippines contribute only 0.2% to the total
greenhouse gases,
GHG.
Mm-hmm.
But we are number 3 in terms of the impacts.
Exactly.
So our interest is in adaptation.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, paying for. So I'm actually there as a collector. I have to collect on the historical responsibilities, mga utang ng mga mayamang countries,
mm-hmm,
kasi nga hindi tayo makaungus-ungus,
mm-hmm,
because tayo talaga ang doormat ng mga bagyo,
mm-hmm,
and the West Pacific is really very hot and therefore it's creating a lot of the storm.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, if you define climate change right now, the basic impact in one sentence is there will be more stronger typhoon, fewer but stronger typhoons.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yun lang.
So where do we come in? That's the Philippines, and you say we're going to be collecting.
The rich countries wants mitigation because they want to use the money for their own so they can comply with their obligation to reduce their greenhouse gas emissions. So parang you have all these CDM measures, et cetera, so they can comply in terms of reducing their greenhouse gas emissions. Mm-mm. There's adaptation also. Adaptation means you have to pay for the rehabilitation, for the disaster preparedness, for the comprehensive land use plan, for the relocation, for all the other things in order to adapt to the impacts of climate change, in order to reduce economic losses, as well as go for zero casualty in terms of people's death.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Correct me if I'm wrong. I think it's been a decade already since Kyoto Protocol bayan. It's been a decade already or more than. And the argument really there was these countries with bigger emissions really didn't want to sign. And then, as you correctly pointed out, tayo yung nagiging doormat nitong ang climate change.
Yung epekto.
Yung epekto. No? Ito na ngayon, itong fund na pinag-uusapan natin ngayon, is this the way to go around it to make sure that these countries
galing
now
mo talaga.
Are...
galing mo talaga.
To make sure that they're really accountable for the carbon footprint.
You hate it. How better to articulate it? In other words, kasi ang hirap-hirap na magkasundo. O ikaw, 30% ka. Sabi niya sa akin, 15. Kasi kung mag-30 ako, mamamata economy ko. Kasi hindi na ako makakapag-use ng gases. It will be very expensive for me na mapalitan yung mga kotse ko, etc., etc. So, okay, bigyan na lang kami ng pera. Kayo na lang ang mag-mitigate para sa akin. Pero, sabi din namin, aba, hindi po pwede mitigate lang. Babayaran niyo yung mga utang niyo sa amin. Kasi andun na, kaya ang role ko ngayon, because it's still a burning. So, we're trying to transition from the interim secretariat to the independent secretariat. We're trying to put up the hybrid institution. It's almost like an ADB plus UN type. That's the one.
Dinala
ko, baka magtanong ka eh. Just on that decision, we have to write 31 pages. So it's very clear. So it's a very, ang role ko doon is to ensure that the Philippines gets a bigger leverage. I want to make sure that the operating principles upon which that the fund will be guided in the long term, once pumasok yung 30 billion between now and 2020, every year, 30 billion, yun ang mga pangako ni Obama.
Mm-hmm.
Tapos by 2020, 100 billion per year, that's 4 trillion. That's twice as big as our total budget.
But is the Philippines going to be the lone voice on this one, or are you going to stand side by side with the other developing countries as well that have been affected by the severe weather conditions?
Actually, 12. Yung developing countries. Divided tayo, 12 developing, 12 developed countries. Usually naman, may mga kumakampi kaga naman sa atin, like Saudi Arabia, kampi sa atin yan. So may geopolitics din siya. Kuminsan nga yung mga developing countries, yung mga spokesperson ng kabila eh. So, pero ang importante doon, may ilaban natin kasi kailangan may logic and you are able to convince the other members of the board that this is the way forward. So we already have to make a strong case. Why? Number one, although right now, ang decision is critical balance between mitigation. Alimbawa kung may 30 billion, 15 billion to mitigation, 15 billion adaptation. Kasi pabor sa atin kung adaptation. Kagad para sa atin sa Pilipinas.
Okay, let's zero in on that. And because, Governor, really, as important as an issue as climate change and all these weather disturbances is, there seems to be a disconnect pa rin between that issue and the public.
Uh-oh.
Hindi pa rin talagang nauunawaan or hindi pa natin...
50-50 nga eh. Lumabas dun sa SWS survey na commissioned by the World Bank. 45% may konting intindi. Yung walang pagkaintindi, umaabot din ng 46. Mm-hmm. So, basically, kaya kailangan talaga dito media. Para may lapit sa kanila kung ano, that they have a big stake in the way this issue or ano.
Halimbawa po, let's take the case of Albay, for example. How will this fund help Albay in terms of adaptation? Because it also hits food security and loss of lives as well, our harvest, especially in Albay.
Unang-una, hindi ako papayag na utang. Kailangan grant. Pag-utang yan, hindi parang sinipa, pinuspo mo lang yung sipa mo sa akin, parang dinoble mo lang ako. Kaya, alam ba, for example, the funds that were given to us by Spain, which is about 650 million, were all grants. And it was given to Albay to procure. And then the funds given to us by Japan was 400 million for permanent evacuation centers. Also grant. So number one, adaptation. Second, grant, not loans. So yun ang very clear. Yes.
Is that something that is provided for in the administration of the fund, that grants can be given or that loans are the preferred?
Of course, rich countries would always want to.
Loans are preferred.
Yeah. Gusto nila regurgitation, mumog. Yung mga dati na nila. Sa bilangan pa lang, alam na kagad na there's some form of gargling. Na yung dati na lang binigay nila, na kinumit na nila sa atin dati.
Babalik pa na.
Parang constructive compliance sila dun sa pinangako nila. So yun, marami, that is the third level of analysis that you can do. But, kaya nandun ang developing countries. At saka, kaya po ako nandun, the choice, and in fact, I think there is a move within the fund na, well, some people are campaigning for me to become chairman.
So, gusto mo yun, di ba?
Ma'am, hindi na, paano na yung Albay? But basically kasi, I know how it operates. Mm. I mean, I know how local communities and local governments use these funds and what are the modalities, like the timing. Sometimes kasi darating yung pondo, patay na yung tao. So we need like a quick disbursing funds, we need like DPL funds, like development policy loan funds. I mean, I know how these things operate and I've been using them, so I would know more or less how these things work on the ground and in real conditions.
Right. Because before we introduced you, of course, so we could already hear you in the background. We were talking about what supposedly a Metro Manila mayor said was the political reality. Measures to be done, but they refused to do it because it would cost them some kind of political capital when it comes to the elections. How do you deal with that, even if you have such mitigation measures to be funded by the Green Climate Fund?
We can reduce the resistance of the people by making it really attractive to them to move.
You make it sound like it has to be profitable for them.
Ah, no. It means less social cost. Mm. Right. Like kung minsan kasi ililipat mo ni walang access
sa tubig,
walang
transportation,
walang kalsada, walang eskwelahan. Like sa amin sa Albay, may ospital yung mga relocation site, may kapilya, talagang we made sure na it is livable and there's an ecosystem that support habitation.
And where are the identified relocation sites of the government now? Hindi ba dati San Jose del Monte, Bulacan?
Oo.
Ngayon, ano na, Montalban, San Mateo?
Ano ngayon is medium rise. On-site medium rise.
On-site. So hindi mo sila ilalayo.
For informal settlers na hindi sa river, non-vulnerable.
Okay.
Ito muna yung mga squatters. Pero dun sa mga informal settlers na vulnerable like riverbanks, talagang kalawan yata. Like si Gina Lopez doing an extremely good job.
Okay.
And kung ako ngayon, bibigay ko na lang pera sa kanya, tapos bahala ka na dyan.
But that's private sector led.
Hindi. Chairman siya ngayon ng Pasig River.
Okay.
Rehabilitation Commission. Mm. So, I think that's a good chance for us to really clean up that river.
What about the other waterways? Yung mga esteros, yung mga
lahat
smaller
sila,
rivers?
Lahat naman sila tributary ng Pasig River. So, pag di mo maayos ang Pasig River, pag hindi mo ayusin yung estero. So, intrinsically, if you are the chairman of the Pasig River PRRC, you're also in charge of the estero. So, basically, bigyan mo siya ng pera para may mubang tao. Total, Gina also helped us after Riming. And she has an experience about these things are being done. Mm. So, to make these things succeed.
Yeah, but still, even with those kinds of efforts from people like Gina Lopez, it still remains to be the job of the LGU to get these people out of their localities. Pero ayaw pa rin nila dahil nga naman pagdating ng every 3 years, kailangan mo ng boto.
Nagkataon lang kasi yun eh. Sa tingin ko dapat kasi ginawa na yan nung pen, nung walang eleksyon eh.
After Ondoy, nagka-eleksyon na eh, kaya wala pa mong umaalis.
Actually, kasi, hindi lang natin pinagpatuloy. Kasi
2009, Ondoy, di ba? 2010 election.
243 billion yung inahanda nun para sa ano rehab natin for adaptation. Ang problema, hindi natin pinurso kasi nga wala nga tayo tiwala. Well, the people did not trust the former president. So, that thing sort of did not push through.
Mm-mm.
But supposedly, ang number one issue there is really the main disaster risk reduction. Kasi, ganito, Tony, para mas malinaw. 97% of the funds are for response. You have to create sites of deaths, destruction to make people
contribute.
Only 3%, kung wala sila nakikita, I mean, you can have a theoretical risk.
Mm-mm.
So, when these things happen, that is the best chance for you to use those funds for risk reduction.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, it is rehabilitation, but you inject immediately risk reduction. So, building back better elsewhere. So, mm-hmm. don't just build back for these people who lost their homes, but build it up better,
mm-hmm.
mean to say stronger, mm-hmm. and can withstand typhoons. And outside the danger zone, building back better elsewhere. So, yun dapat yung Pepeng Undoy nangyari.
Alright, so before Casey goes in again, if you have that fund and you want to use it for adaptation, would you entrust that fund to local government officials?
Actually, sa amin, halos pinagamit ng mga Spaniards, ang AC, pinagamit sa amin ng JB, pinagamit sa amin ng USAID. Pero lahat naman sila dumadaan sa NEDA kasi nire-register yan. Tinitina kung kung incompatible sa national priorities at saka national goals.
Okay.
So there are enough existing, how do you call that? Operating environment. I mean, in terms of principles and guidelines, oversight, etc.
Safeguards.
Mm-mm. Now, how do you then disburse the fund? Do the LGUs go to you, present their profile, their plan?
NIE, National Implementing Entity.
Mm-mm.
And right now in the Philippines, that would be the choice of the Climate Change Commission.
Aha.
So, ayun ang dyan nauunang Pilipinas. Sa buong mundo tayo nauna nag-create ng Climate Change Commission. I think we would say now from a legislative point of view, we probably have one of the best legal infrastructure for disaster risk reduction and climate change adaptation in the whole world.
And just as a final point, Governor, how will this fund now exist in conjunction with our People's Survival Fund?
Yung People's Survival Fund is a nice fund na kung saan pwede namin isaksak. Actually, if I, for example, once this fund starts to operate, I hope I'm still there. My intention really is to use the People's
Survival
Fund as a conduit.
So doon na,
kasi yung 1 billion
there.
Naman yun, parang sinabi lang 1 billion bibigyan ng gobyerno. Pero yung operating
yun
principles, yung priorities, yung philosophy, yung kanilang mechanisms, yun ang... Bakit ko pa uulitin? Kung pinag-isipan na maigi yun ng mga legislators at saka ng mga local, ng mga INGOs, NGOs, and local governments and local communities. So, marami ng, there's too much brain on that basket already. So, why would not I use it, di ba? So, I mean, if I were, that would be a logical conduit for the Green Climate Fund once it starts to operate. But right now, all I'm fighting for is, number one, more money for adaptation.
Mm.
Second, more grants than loans.
Yeah.
And the third one, no regurgitation. No gargling. It should be new money. It should be fresh. It should not be something na kinumit mo na 10 years ago, tapos ngayon, compliance pa rin yun. So, I mean...
All right, so you've got this nice IT
building
in, what is it, Incheon?
Incheon.
So are you actually scheduled to have any preliminary meetings now with them?
Actually, it will be a fourth
meeting already. Okay.
Pero I'm di yata ako dahil I want to attend yung ano nakita ko kasi sa TV.
Yung
ano meron kayo summit on climate change. Sabi ko paalam muna ako kasi mas mahalaga para sa akin yung makausap ko ang tao natin.
And Coco Alcoas will be pleased that you'll be there.
Kasi marami nang there's a lot of these pre-caucuses that are happening. Alam mo naman kami nagkakumpanyahan kung sino, kung saan okay. mapupunta, kung anong, kumisan choice of words pa lang, pinag-aaway-awayan di ba? So, meron naman tayong mga galing na mga technocrats. Actually, one of the coordinator for G77 plus China is a Filipina. She's Ambassador Dita Smaller. She's the best.
All right.
Actually, there's always a Filipinos the best in WTO.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. There's a Filipinos the best in climate change sa negotiation. Okay. In fact, when you talk about negotiation, kung sino nakakalam to the last semicolon, it's a Filipina. It's Ambassador Dita Smaller. Mm-hmm. And so I rely totally on her. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, I give my own inputs in terms of one, mm-hmm. how local governments use the money and what are the types of money we need. Mm-hmm. And second, in terms of my own investment banking background, since I came from Swiss Bank and I worked for much of my professional life there before I fell into politics. So,
all right. Well, of course, we're looking forward to the continued discussions on this Green Climate Fund and whether
sinira
or not...
Sinira nga ng ANC yung schedule.
Really?
Hindi, kasi...
All for a good thing. All for a good cause.
Bukas, sabi ko wag na muna kasi yung 25 gusto kong... I want to be there.
Yeah.
I really made a choice. I want to be there because this is a chance for me because I saw the SWS survey showing that half of the people don't understand it at all. So, I mean, it's the chance.
Well, we'll try to actually increase that percentage
I think you two
when
should
the
be
forum
there.
Time... The forum time comes around. Governor Salceda, a pleasure to have you on the show.
Always,
thank you very
much. Always a pleasure. Maraming salamat po.